So you're the one who needs an MRI scan of your knee. Well, let's talk a little bit about what MRI shows, what you can expect, and when you're having the MRI, and depending on the result, what's going to happen next. Remember that MRI is really good at showing the soft tissue of the knee. That's the ligaments, like the anterior cruciate ligament, and the meniscus, the cartilage that sits between the leg bone and the thigh bone. So if you have a tear of the anterior cruciate ligament, or you have a rip in your meniscus, an MRI is definitely going to be the way to show it. There's one other thing that an MRI shows extremely well, and that's a loose body. I'm not kidding. That's what it's called, a loose body. All right, let's talk about them one at a time. First, a sprain. I often get the question, hey, what's the difference between a sprain and a strain? There isn't any. The joint hurts because it's absorbed more force than it can handle, but nothing's broken. So on the inside, there's no ligament tear, there's no new meniscal injury. There might be swelling, but there's no other structural kind of a problem. Second issue is a ligament injury. Remember, a ligament is just a piece of tissue that connects two bones. In this case, the thigh bone and the leg bone. The most common ligament injury of the knee is the anterior, means the front one, cruciate, there's two of them and they make a cross, ligament, thingy that connects bone to a bone. So anterior cruciate ligament. Guys playing basketball, professional football, soccer, sports injury where you get up, you run, you stop and pivot, and your body goes one way, but your knee goes the other, tears the ligament. Horrible injury, season ending for most athletes, but not the end. You can have a reconstruction and come back just as good as new. What you don't hear about as often is actually more common, and that is you were getting out of the car and your anterior cruciate ligament tore. Well, how can that be? Obviously, it wasn't healthy to begin with. It was about to go, and some routine motion was the straw that broke the camel's back. I guess the take-home message is, we associate anterior cruciate ligament injuries with sports because that's where they happen, but they also can happen when you're not doing a sport, just when you're doing an everyday thing. How do you know if you got one then? It's the slipping, the sense of grinding and instability of your knee. If you're walking and you feel like your knee isn't safe and you can't walk on it, it could be an anterior cruciate ligament injury. Meniscus injuries. The meniscus is a horseshoe piece of cartilage, there's two of them in each knee, that separates the leg bone from the thigh bone and acts as a cushion to buffer between the two. Depending on the force that's applied or even an injury of everyday life, can rip the meniscus and cause a lot of pain. The way it feels and the symptoms are your knee is locked and you don't want to straighten it out. Meniscus injuries are very treatable. A very minor arthroscopic surgery is done. During the surgery, this orthopedic surgeon who's trained in sports medicine makes a nick in the skin, puts in an arthroscope, cleans out the part of the meniscus that's damaged and is ratty. That's a kind of a roto-rooter. That's called meniscectomy. And in some cases, in younger folks, the meniscus actually is so badly damaged, it needs to be repaired, even sewed back together or tacked down. And that's called meniscal repair. So meniscectomy or meniscal repair are both highly effective. Pain relief is immediate. You're back on your feet when you walk out of the surgery center. Really great surgery, great outcome, and quick recovery. The next thing are kneecap problems. The kneecap, the patella, is part of the knee joint. Between the patella and the femur, it's called the patellofemoral joint. And if you get arthritis in there, it hurts. Every time you move your kneecap is ratty and is having a hard time sliding over the femur below. That's patellofemoral syndrome called chondromalacia. Chondromalacia. They can go in there with a scope and scrape off or peel off the damaged cartilage, and that makes a lot of people feel better for some time. If you have that, quite frankly, you got arthritis, you're probably on your way to a total knee, but that might be something that can buy you a little bit of time. There's a real thick tendon that goes between the kneecap and the tibia, the patellofemoral tendon can be injured in either running or jumping. And depending on where you injure it and how you injure it, that's often called runner's knee or jumper's knee. Another thing that shows up on MRI, you might see it on a report, and can be treated. Loose body is not what happens to your body after you turn 50. Loose body is actually a piece of cartilage that's broken off the knee joint and is floating around in the fluid space of the knee and can get locked in one position or another. If a loose body gets locked in your knee, you get the same symptom you have if you have a meniscal tear. Namely, your knee is bent and you cannot straighten it up. There is great treatment for a loose body. It's actually one of the easiest operations that the orthopedic surgeons do. All they do is put a scope inside the knee joint, look around until they see that little piece of cartilage that's broken off. They grab it and pull it out, the operation's over. The recovery is really minimal and the relief is instantaneous. This is a home run procedure, very easy to get better and great bang for your buck, so to speak. Anterior cruciate ligament surgery is an excellent surgery, but it does have requires a very extensive rehabilitation. The hard part about anterior cruciate ligament reconstruction surgery isn't the surgery, it's the rehab. The rehab goes on for weeks and in many cases, depending on the sport, months after the surgery. How come? Well, part of it is the graft heals in bone to bone, and bone healing, it's like a broken bone, it takes longer. The second part is that's the stability of the knee, the strength of the knee. Once it's strong enough that you can start putting weight on it, you've had some atrophy. Then you gotta get back and build your strength, and that can take a long time. Hey, are you sick and tired of my face? Well, you can get all this on a brochure and read it if you want to. Let us know, fill out the form below, type in your contact, and we can send you a brochure by mail. Also, we could send you a PDF. If you're okay with an email, we can send it to you that way and so you can take a look. Our Moving On brochures are a really great way to find out what are the possibilities, what are the things that could be wrong with my knee, and what do I need to do about it?